Hey everybody, so today I will be cooking some candied sweet potatoes, but vegan style. So I don't know about you, but the way I'm used to having them is with a lot of butter, which I love, but I can no longer have that. So I'm gonna be switching out a few things, also trying out some coconut sugar instead of regular sugar, and we're gonna see how this goes. So let's get right into it. So I'm gonna be starting with 4 sweet potatoes. They're on the small to medium side, so I'm gonna do that. Make sure you wash them real good. I like to use like a little brush scrubber or something like that. And then, so I've done that already, so now I'm gonna get them peeled. Of course, with that, you have the option to peel them with like a vegetable peeler, or if you want to use a knife, I like to use a peeler. It's a little bit easier for me. After I get them all peeled, I like to rinse them off just a little bit. Man, I personally prefer the smaller sweet potatoes or the more skinny ones, because to me, they're a little bit more easy to slice. So that's what I like to get. So I'm gonna take about 1.5 cups of water. And then after the water, I'm gonna take my butter and get that in there. The vegan butter, that Meagan's that I really like. If you haven't tried it, to me, it tastes just like a good dairy butter. I'm gonna be using close to what would be like maybe a stick of butter in a normal longer stick.
Oh, but she can't. She gonna save every last drop.
I don't like to waste.
I swear you don't.
Putting 1 tablespoon of vanilla flavor. And you want to make sure you use pure vanilla. Then I'm going to put 2 heaping tablespoons of cinnamon. And then I'm putting in about 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg. I'm not a huge nutmeg person, so I personally don't like to go overboard with that, but it is good to get a little bit of that flavor in there. I'm just mixing that up a little bit. And then I'm also using coconut sugar. That's what that looks like. I'm putting about 1 cup of coconut sugar. It almost looks like brown sugar. And you just want to make sure you stir that up real good to get all the ingredients mixed together. Then you can go ahead and put the sweet potatoes in there. You want to make sure you don't just let them fall in there and then get popped with the mixture.
Everybody getting them popper grease before?
Oh, I have. That's what I'm trying to avoid.
Girl, if you don't dump that whole thing in there.
You want to get popped? Come a little closer. Come a little closer.
I'm standing back here and then just pull it. You got the long sleeve on.
I've definitely had my war wounds from the kitchen. I'm just going to push them down in there to let the mixture cover them. You want to make sure that they did come to a boil, and then you're just going to simmer them and put the lid on them. Because this wasn't a big amount, I'm probably going to let them cook to like 25, 30 minutes and kind of see how they are. You want to make sure they get nice and tender. Then I'm just gonna turn down my heat a little bit to let them simmer for a while. If you're wondering what coconut sugar is, it says on the package that the coconut sugar is made from the flower bud cut from coconut palm, and the glycemic index is lower than regular sugar. So it's supposed to be a little bit more healthy for you than regular sugar.
I tell you, vegan or non-vegan, it smells good.
Yes, it does. It does. And then I was also gonna tell you, like, even with the butter option, so I use the vegan butter for this recipe. And then I haven't tried this for sweet potatoes, but for candied sweet potatoes, I have with regular sweet potatoes if I roast them in the oven, that kind of thing. But I may try that at some point too. It's a coconut oil that has like a butter flavor. Well, now I'm just checking them. I've been kind of stirring them a little bit just to see if they need to keep cooking. You want them to be tender. I might let them cook down just a little bit more. All right, so it's been cooking for about 1/2 hour now, maybe like 35 minutes, so it should be ready. They were almost ready before, but I just wanted them to cook a little bit longer, get a little bit more tender. I'm gonna let them keep cooking uncovered for maybe about 10 more minutes, just to let the mixture, the butter and the sugar, all of that just get a little bit thicker. All right, so we just finished the sweet potatoes, the candy sweet potatoes, candy and whatever you want to call them. So, Keith, you ready to try these? They smelling good, right?
They smell like candy yam. So, we're going to see. Let's see.
That's what it is.
All right. Give me a nice little piece.
Okay. I'm going to get you a good one. You really aren't a big...
sweet potato eater.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
Let me taste one.
That's tasting like a candy yam right there.
It is. That little coconut sugar.
It did a trick.
And that Miyoko's butter, it did its thing.
Whatever Miyoko.
That, ooh. I'm excited, y'all. I'm excited.
Megan's been dancing around just smelling it. She couldn't wait to taste it. Then it came out good.
You know why, though? Because during the holidays, now I can have all the regular food that everybody else is having. I just got to make my little tweaks. And shout out to my grandmother because I pretty much did the same thing that she does as far as the seasonings that I use. And I just switched out a few things instead of using, I think she uses brown sugar. So instead of using that, I use the coconut sugar and then the vegan butter. But everything else is pretty much the same. She's usually making it in a much bigger batch. So I don't know if our measurements were, you know, that's different, but overall, same thing. So, love you, Grandma. Thank you. All these right, are bomb.
Meagan the Vegan strikes again.
Yes. I mean all of these. Yes. Wow. I'm hyped. When you're vegan and gluten-free, you get excited when you get a good... when your recipe turns out right, because every time it don't always come out right.
Well, this one came out right. Listen, if y'all got any more suggestions for anything that y'all want Megan to cook or some different recipes, she's definitely open for all the suggestions. Put them in the comments below.
He putting me to work.
I think you're helping some people. I think if anybody's a vegan like you, you know what I'm saying? These are some great, great recipes that I think you would truly love. All right, y'all, do us a favor. Like, share, and subscribe.
Yes, thank y'all.
You're cooking with the beggars on this one.
Wow.
Good job. You can brag about those.